Universal is a software termed as video-based LMS. What is the meaning of video-based LMS? Let us see. For example, whenever we start sharing video with our students, there is no accountability. Whenever we start sharing the video, we may share with WhatsApp, or we may give YouTube link, or we may give Google Drive. Now, yesterday Google Drive recorded video we have shared. There is no guarantee how many of you downloaded, how many of you watched. I may not be able to track. So for that, what is the substitution is, 8Puzzle is a software. It is termed as video-based LMS, learning management system. And it is useful for blended learning. It is useful for flipped learning. Beyond that, what is the use of 8Puzzle? We can identify any video across the internet, or we can upload our own video from the desktop. Any video we bring to 8Puzzle, it is closed to your own circle. To whom you are sharing that 8Puzzle code, they only will be the stakeholder of that video. It is like a Google Classroom. It's a closed environment. It's not a public environment. So number one. Number two, this 8Puzzle will have accountability tracking mechanism. With the video, the moment I bring into 8Puzzle, the moment all my audiences or my learners are included into 8Puzzle, either by the teacher or by the students. Two way we can invite people, like a Google Classroom. Once all the students are invited here, I can keep tracking how many of you watched, how many of you not watched, how many of you watched, what time, what date, how much the portion of video watched. I will show you the demonstration shortly. I have the video admin detailed record of how I administered for my students. That is the main purpose of 8Puzzle. Next, this is the URL. That just you can type 8Puzzle in the Google, then it will take us to that URL. This is a emblem. It has, these are all the features. It will allow us to cut the video, trim the video. Suppose unwanted portion of the video is available, then we can trim easily with that option, or crop it. Either it will be trim or crop word. Next, it will allow us to create audio notes. Audio notes, what is the meaning? I will tell a little bit late. One more option is it will allow us to do voice over. What is the meaning of voice over is, I can pick one of the male professor video. Then within the 8Puzzle only, I'm not modifying his original YouTube video. I can bring that male professor YouTube video to the 8Puzzle. He would have created with a complicated mathematical equations and diagrams. I don't want to do anything. Then I can wipe away that voice. I can articulate my voice. Some of the faculty member will feel afraid. Madam, copyright issue, not at all issue. It is only for your students you are doing, you are not changing the original. With that copyright conflict interest only, this 8Puzzle has created. Number one. Number two, it is up to your individual ethic. That's all I can say. Suppose I'm bringing one male professor video, and I'm not only male professor, just for distinguishing the voice, I'm telling you, I can pick any female professor video also. I can wipe away the entire voice. If at all that professor appears on the video, then it will not suit. If they are not appearing, only the text matter and diagrammatic matter and equations, then I can reuse. Depending upon the speed of that existing video, I may need to cope up my pace of articulation. That is a notable point. That is another option. Audio note, what is the meaning is, I can pick somebody's video to my student. Across the video, as much as possible, I can give my audio notes. That is why I use the male professor videos. One of the male professor video I'm picking, and I can give in initial beginning of the video, I can articulate like this. This is a video talks about two-stroke engine. Dear students, this seems to be very good articulation it has. You please watch, let us have further discussion in the classroom. Like that, you can give audio notes. In the middle of the video also, you can do as many audio notes. For example, that professor may be giving applications of two-stroke engine in the real time. Then he may be giving only three examples. You know, maybe five examples. So in between, you can intervene with audio notes. You can articulate rest of your stuff. So that the touch will be there. Your students will feel that you are also bringing a touch with that video. Then last option is, it will allow us to set MCQ type of questions. Polling it will allow. And notes, text notes also we can pop up through the video, along with the video, substitute type questions also. There is a spelling mistake type. Okay. Then engage your videos with video content, enables self-paced learning, useful for flipped learning and blended learning, home learning activities we can use, allow to track your students' understanding of the concept and misconceptions, because we are setting the question, diagnostic question across the video. So it is a way to understand misconceptions and how good the quality of learning happened, allows to create class. That means yesterday I said, no, third CSE, second CSE, third MEC, first year ECE, something like that. Allows to create an interactive videos within the class. That's all. Now, it allows to create audio notes. It allows to do voiceover. It allows to insert and cut. This voiceover, I need to change it to cut. MCQ, text notes, polling, subject type question. These are all the possibility with the Prezi. Sorry. Edpuzzle. I am doing Prezi, so it has come Prezi. Now we go for hands-on session. Just type Edpuzzle, enter, click this Edpuzzle. I would have been logged in. Let me log out and show you. Log out, login. This is how it will look. The moment you come to home page of this Edpuzzle, it shows you, I am a teacher, I am a student. We need to click, I am a teacher. Oh, 1 minute. Yeah, sign in with Google. This is what I was searching for. Sign in with Google. We can sign in with any one of the Gmail. As I said, edu.in, ac.in, something like that. So if you look at this home page, we may need to concentrate here. Curriculum, institution name, these are all the way. My content, if you click, all my contents it will show. If I click my content. Content, gradebook. I want to show you only one content, this content. Within this content, see, it says that 10-14 timeline of that video, open-ended question I have said. 21:29 timeline. 22:05. I have set open-ended question. See, this bubble-like or inserted element over the video. Now let me show you gradebook. Within the gradebook, I didn't do grading because all are open-ended questions. That is kind of feedback. My classes, this gradebook shows start date and due date. May 29th, 2019. This video has been created, that year is not coming. My classes, see, due assignment, it has come. 143 answers I have received. 44 students watched this video out of 68 students. Now I need to click this to see that what and all students answer. What is a question? These are all the questions I have read. Do you feel this video is useful for your learning? Please share your views. This is what I was asking to my student. Then thank you for watching. Give your valuable feedback for this video. Then let me hear your doubts in my contact class. Meet you soon. Then for this question, students typed yes, yes, yes. For this question, yes, madam, useful. Or some they don't say madam, yes, useful. Here do you feel? Then they started expressing. Now let us see, students. See, it shows who watched. Nagamonika watched 90%. Pallavi watched 90%. This is what date they watched. Not turned in. On time, late. What is late means? I may be setting the due date, January 23rd. So beyond 23rd, if anybody wanted to watch, it will allow. But it won't, it will be marking at us late. On time, late, it will mark. Next is prevent skipping. This button, if it is toggled on, it won't allow to drag the video. Suppose while watching movie, if you don't like fight scenes, no, I will skip the fight scenes. So like that, it is not possible. Edpuzzle, the video is brought, students cannot skip the video. The prevent skipping should be toggled on. Another added advantage of Edpuzzle is, if at all I am playing the video and I want to work with my Microsoft Word and draft the mail, it won't allow. Within this window, if I am there, only then it will play the video. The moment I come out of, that is called locking the screen. If I come out of the screen, it won't play. Now, see, these are all the people didn't turn and watch. 0% watched. 40% watched. These are all the indications we used to get. If you look at this is a kind of gang, one gang, whatever I say they don't do. So that gang only didn't do. If you come here, it's reached. Questions we have seen, students we have seen. Next questions we need to see answers. 50% to good. For this question, do you feel this video is useful? They have mentioned yes. Yes, ma'am, I feel this video is useful for our learning. I understood. This is the first exercise I had given in the very first few days of my class, because I wanted to know how much involvement, who are all inclined to learning, who are all self-motivated, who have a good expressive skill. Like that, I used to group my students. I used to understand. It's a main, always understanding our audience is the first objective of the teacher. So within first week, I used to conduct a pre-survey. I used to understand their mindset, their learning inclination, and I used to give some video, and I will understand their articulation, writing skill, and who is getting connected with me and who is getting connected with the subject matter. All those things I will segregate. After that, I will drive my class. For that purpose, I have brought this video. Then after that, they were telling, madam, don't put a video in the 8% like that, because it is tracking now, so that they were opposing. So this is a just I'm showcasing, I didn't start the demo yet. That's it. Let us come back to content. So these are all the showcase of the existing video. Now let us go to my content. First, we need, very first, what video we need to bring, that video URL we need to copy. This is the video about Prezi I want to make to my students to watch, for example. Now I need to click my content. See, left hand side, my content option is available. Please click this content, this option. Then you may see add content, refer to earn space. This all released 1 year ago. Maybe more than 6,000 faculty I would have introduced, but never I earned this space. Now add content, click the add content. Please pay your attention here. Create a video, upload a video, student project, new folder. Create a video is to create the existing YouTube video. Upload a video is for uploading our video which we have recorded using Zoom or any kind of software. Some faculty said Loom. These are all the kind of software, a flashback recorder. What video you have recorded, that video. Student project, it is locked. Right now, whenever I explored, 2 years ago I used this, it was locked. What is the meaning is students can upload their video. I will emphasize here, any English faculty available here, you can make use of this benefit. What is the meaning is, especially this lockdown time, the students project, for example, English teacher always will be correcting the accent, pronunciation, articulation, body language, facial expression, these all. When really we are asking our students to articulate in a class, we'll be noting down on a paper. Then at the end of the presentation only, we'll be commenting. We'll be giving our feedback and the closure. Hey guy, you didn't do this well. By that time, the presenter will forget the way he or she presented. Whereas we can ask our students to create a video. That video can be submitted through this student project. Then teacher can comment on the timeline. At this juncture, your pronunciation need to be corrected. At this juncture, your articulation need to be improved. Here, your energy level gone down. Here, you are having good expressive skill. Here, you may change your facial expression. Or in that kind of added advantage, I can see with the help of this 8% student project. New folder, that is just to create a folder for the CSEA section. You may create unit 1, unit 2, unit 3, something like that. For that, that's it. Now, upload a video, I don't want to do because it will waste my time. Lot of time it will take. I have plenty of video on my desktop, but it will take a lot of time. So I'm going to do create a video. Please listen, create a video. There is no big change. There are two changes. Everything will look same. But here, upload file. All the time, Google Form itself, I'm uploading a lot of files. No, it's like that. Now create a video, click it. Now it will come like that. Don't worry. After clicking create a video, please pay your attention. Left hand side you come, click YouTube. Then paste the URL which you picked from the YouTube. Automatically it will come to this mode. We have come to the 8% customizing mode. Let me reduce the size so that What is this? It's increasing rather control minus V. Collapsed. 1 minute, something went wrong. Okay, close this, then I come back. 8 puzzle. The focus is only for 8 puzzle, so that it is doing differently. Yeah, it has loaded. I'll delete two times. It is loaded. I'll delete this. Delete. Everything deleted. Now newly I will start from the beginning. So add content, create a project, click YouTube, paste the URL. I'll give you a short break in 5-10 minutes. Over. Now we have brought the video which we are interested to administer to our students to the 8-puzzle customizing mode. We need to click the cut. The moment we click cut, see white color nails will come. In this video, it will play, it will show you, it is playing, audio I am only able to listen. See, this is middle of the, any portion, trailing, leading portion or middle of the video, any portion. If you don't want the last 10 minutes, use, don't touch the beginning thumbnail, only the last thumbnail. If you want to retain this, retain. It will do n number of times, it will allow you to customize. Now I want to trim only first 5, 10 minutes, 11 minutes, 54 seconds. I want to 12 minutes, 44 seconds only. I want to keep for my students. This video is of about 49 minutes I have articulated. Now only 13 minutes I want to administer. Ready now. Now what I should do is, after this, nothing we can do. Reset we need to do. Reset. See. Click the, look at this button. Undo means something I did, but wrongly I did undo. Reset if I do, the entire original video is, see, now changed. Not 48 minutes, 12.44. Compressed to what is the desired portion, I have cropped, I have trimmed. Now that is over. Next, voice over. Now interesting part we have come, voice over. Now the moment I click, start recording will come. The moment I press the start recording, it started recording. Now the video is all about Prezi. Right now I am having the contact class upon 8-puzzle software. Now whatever I am, right now I am articulating, these all will get a voiceover. If you want to articulate throughout the video, you need to articulate. Half of the video only you want to narrate. Remaining half of the video, that existing professor video you want to continue, you can continue. So mix and match also is possible. So first 5 minutes you can articulate with your voice or your narration. Rest of the video you can retain. So 36 seconds recorded. This 36 second, what would be there? Not the Prezi. What I am articulating right now in the session will be recorded. Till now what I am speaking. The moment I stop recording, it will take, see, now it is bubbling. Progress, it is showing, progress bar. Until that settle down, I need to a little bit be quiet. So now up to this, and you can do there, you want to give voice over also possible. You can drag and go to that portion of the video, maybe erratic occurrence or anything, maybe then you can continue. See, what I did is wrongly I did. I started my recording from this portion, not from the beginning. Middle of the video only I started recording, voice over. Then first 10 minutes that professor video maybe, then continuation is my voice. So this is the added advantage. If you want to, you can use it. It's all up to your choice. Next is questions. If we click this questions option, we can have three more options. Under questions button or tab, multiple choice questions, open-ended questions, note. Multiple choice question, auto evaluation will happen. Here we can't set the mark. If you set only one question across the video, 100 marks. If your students happen to become wrong for the question, they will get 0. If you set 2 questions, each question will be carried with 50 marks. So it will divide, it will equate to 100 number of questions. That is the distribution of mark. So next to open-ended question. Open-ended question, it is possible, but we need to evaluate like a Google form. Note, here there are two types of notes. Again, further, text note, audio note. Let me click multiple choice. One by one I will go. Which is proof? The same question. I'll show you another advantage. You have mathematical equation, that code cox. Yesterday we have seen, no, code cox. That code cox editor will come. That code cox editor, you can edit your mathematical equation, then it will be imbibed. For example, I'm going to use this one. X into X divided by Y into Y. Okay, if I click which is fruit, along with I'm setting one equation also. If you want, you write another. You can insert picture also. With the picture also, you can upload a picture. Use URL. Internet means use URL. Upload a picture. So you can upload a picture, or you can upload one URL. Now one website. What is the meaning is, during the video play, it will give you a pop-up message, that URL. Students need to click and read that URL, come back. That is the meaning. So we can give video link, text link, or web link, or we can give image, or we can give mathematical equation. This is Superscript subscript. Already it is available in the code cox. And you can format also, which is fruit. This is very potential keyword I can highlight. That's all. Now font size and all you can do, or underline. Now very first tick mark will be there. That you toggle off. That's all. I am going to give the same order. Tree, lotus. Now click add another answer. Lotus, peacock, add another answer. Apple. Now here there is a tick mark, gray color. You can notice. I can see on my monitor. You can prominently, you can see red color, but that gray color tick won't see. I'm clicking. Which is the right answer? You need to click, and you need to be sure that the first should not be toggled on. Two answers also you can give. Each answer, then 50-50 marks it will come. If you are setting one question, toggle off, over. Now we need to click save. Now before that, we need to be very careful where we want to set this question. That pointer we need to bring. See, this is the point I want. Fifth minute only I want to set. After setting that only we need to come. Otherwise, zigzag it will go. Before watching the video, if question goes, no, who will answer? So you need to articulate. Students need to learn. Then only they can answer. As say, now it had gone to fifth. See, this moment it had gone. The question had gone to 5:36. Here only the question had come. Now I need to move to somewhere this ball. Then I can go for continue. See, click the continue. First question I have come, continue. Now open-ended question. Over. One demo only I am giving. You can do as much as whichever you want. Now I am going to open-ended question. So do you like this video? Or subject matter, articulate or list out the applications of four-stroke engine. You can write like that, or articulate some definition in your own words, something like that. Then save. That's all. Here also you can do the same, bold, italic, applications of four-stroke engine, bold, image, link, code cox, equation editor, something like that. Click save. Now this is the point it had come. Now we need to move to some other place, then another place, then continue. Then note. Here you can give just a text note or same method. Let us meet you soon in the class. Anything like that. We will discuss, or I will clarify your doubts on meeting the next session. Say, over. Now another. I need to put appropriate place. Then continue. Now again note. This note, see here there is a microphone icon. This is for audio note. The earlier note which I demonstrated is for text note. Now we need to click this audio note. Hi guys, hope you would have enjoyed watching this video. Let us meet in the class. I'll be conducting learning activities upon this topic. Get well prepared. Then these marks upon the learning activity I'll be considering for your internal marks. Over. End. Now this audio notes save. Whatever I articulated right now, that audio notes had gone. Similarly, audio note. If you want to play audio note, it will play. Whenever audio note had come, the video will be stopped for a while. Then that audio note will be played. This is how it works.
So this Madam, there is a question. There is a question on the chat box.
Yeah, I'll consider. Link for the video. Yeah, edited. That is what Google. I will come back there. Not yet completed. The 8%. Please wait, ma'am. I'll come back. This question, I am on the way, sir. I need to drive further. So, like a cooking, then I need to offer. No, of course, I need to serve to my family members. It's like that. Now I am cooking. I will offer. How to offer? I will tell you what type of plate, everything. Don't worry. Now these are all over. No, continue. No more. Only 4 demo I wanted to do. Cut, voice over. Within the questions, I wanted to do these 4. These 4 I wanted to. That's all. So these 4 within these 2 and these 2. That's why these 4 I'm telling. Note, audio note, and text note. 2 type of notes, which is possible. I said. Now everything is over. Whatever I want to do, I am done. Now you need to click finish. Finish is over. See, it is telling multiple choice, open-ended question I have said, and edit further. If you want to edit, you can click edit. It is possible. Now, if you look at delete, if you want to delete it, duplicate it with the same changes, CSCA section, CSCB section, give separate video. Now assign for that chat box question, now only answer going to come. You can pick up from this point onwards for getting clarity. Click assign. Now these are all summary, what I did, what I went right, went wrong, that's all. I may need to click assign. When I assign, see, this is the classroom, Aurora, first year S15, Krishna University. Yes, these are all the classes for, see, otherwise add new class, I'll create track analytics. Create class, new class. This video I want to assign. Before that, prevent skipping, ensure it should be. Today, then due date. Today itself I'm going to give, or you can change the date also. And due date, before July 16th, I'm expecting my students to watch before 12 o'clock. July 16th, time. Why it is not assigned? July 5th. July 1st to due date, July 9th. Nothing is changing. What happened? Yeah. Let me click later. I'll come back, assign. Then today, July 1st to July 22nd. This is the way I used to do, but today it's not all working. Start date of the video assignment for our students today, end date is July 5th. Yeah, save. I didn't notice. Save. If you want to change the time, you change. Otherwise, save. You need to click the save button. Over. Now, prevent skipping, we need to assign later. Assign due date 16th. First to July 15th, save. Yeah, save. Next, I need to choose the class. Assign. Choose the class, assign all, assign. Now assign over to the class to whom I want to do. Now, how to share this video to my CSEA section is the question that madam asked. Just copy paste this link and share. Enough. This copy paste link and share. That you need to go to that particular video, or else see, look at right hand side, go live. This all recently they have brought share assignment. You could see the button share assignment, copy the link. Now right now if I share in the chat box, you all would be a student of this video. Whomever it goes, they all will become my audience. That's all. So this copy link, share wherever you want to get. The question is, may I share in Google Classroom? Yes, you can share in Google Classroom. share in WhatsApp, copy link, share in the mail, share in draft your mail, and WhatsApp status also you can keep. Where you want to, Facebook, LinkedIn, any part, the link is there. What you want to do, you do. Over. Copy code. This is another way. Through code, students can join. Otherwise, this, not record that copy code. This one method is sufficient. Over. See, I will come back. I need to go to content. This is the content. Or this content I want to show. Every time for the demo, I will be doing this one. Now, let me click praise. This is the content. Look at this content, assign you can give, after assigning which class you want to assign, assign. After assigning, you can see share assignment. This one you can click, or else direct copy this URL, both way it will work. But little bit difference between direct copy and share assignment, but it will work for the students. Share assignment, that's all. If you click share assignment, all the time it will be available. It is like a unique code, copy link. Then you can share with your students. Escape. To come out of this pain, you need to press escape. Now 8% almost over. Now it is 11:15.